Applying audio transitions can really help your video keep flowing, but it's a very tedious process dragging in the crossfade onto every single cut that you've made. But what if I were to tell you that there is a setting called batch fades where you can add crossfades, fade ins, fade outs to thousands of different clips in a matter of seconds. You won't believe me? Let me show you. So here we are inside of DaVinci Resolve, and this is one of my most recent projects. It's a tutorial for this YouTube channel. And audio track number one is my voice. It's like just talking. It has 25 clips, so it's a pretty small tutorial. But if I have to drag in the crossfade onto every single one of those cuts, that would be pretty time consuming. So I'm not gonna do that. Instead, I just close the effects library. I go into the Fairlight page, and in the Fairlight page, all I wanna do is just go up with my mouse until I see Fairlight, click on that, scroll down until I see batch fade settings. And this is where you wanna click on. So just click on batch fade settings and this window will pop up. First of all, you have the control over fade in, crossfade and fade out. You can deactivate them as you would like or just leave them activated as I do. Then you can choose the fade unit. If you're an audio guy, you can choose milliseconds. If you're more into video, of course, you wanna choose frames. So then the next step is determining the curve of your fade in, your crossfade, and your fade out. So I have my fade in set to a linear curve. I got my crossfade set to equal power, which basically just boosts the audio by 3 decibels in the middle of the transition. And I set this to the log fade and log fade. I have my fade out set to exponential fade. And the length of them is on the fade in and fade out is 3 frames. So on the crossfade, it is set to 2 frames. And what I like the most about it is if I have already done some previous fadings manually in the edit page, I can choose override existing, which just overrides them, or I can leave this unchecked, which will leave those transitions done previously untouched. So what I'm gonna do is after I've set everything up here, I'm gonna hit apply. So then what I wanna do is I'm gonna select my range selection tool and then highlight all the clips where I want the fades to be applied on. So in this case, it's the full audio track number one. And once I've highlighted them, I'm gonna go up until I see Fairlight and then apply batch fades. And if I'm gonna zoom in to demonstrate to you, as you can see, I have applied a bunch of crossfades across my audio track number one. This is how simple it is to apply audio fades to thousands of clips within just a few seconds. And I still believe all of you guys should do this because this ultimately helps your video keep flowing so much more. But yeah, guys, that's a wrap. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If so, please consider leaving a like and a subscribe if you haven't already to not miss out on any upcoming content in the future, but also to help me spread out this video to more people that might be interested in that specific topic. But with that being said, guys, I hope you all have a great day. See you in the next one. Bye.